Hello, folks. Welcome. Just following on with the jar that we you saw me trim it. I've got here a tool which is fashioned out of a bit of strapping. It's got a bit of a rounded end, and then it has a more of a flatter end on that end. And I'm going to try to flute this jar. So why don't you join me? We'll switch the light on and we'll get down there a little bit closer in where the action is. So just bear with me as I bring this in a bit. Okay, I think that's about right. Now, I have to wear some glasses because so here we are. Now, just one or two things to say here about doing fluting. If you are going to flute, best not to have the surface of the pot too rough and, you know, like a plowed field. Sort of make sure it's fairly smooth. I have put a line along around there. I don't know if you can see that. It's just to help me, just to know where I'm starting from. So, without further ado, I'm going to start shaving, paring away the clay. Now, when you do fluting, understand that it's a movement basically from the elbow here. Okay, so keep your arm tight into your side. Okay, get in a comfortable position, and then you basically are doing this movement like that. So. Sometimes you need to do several strokes down on the same. The challenge when doing this is to keep it going down vertical. And sometimes they do veer off. And then you have to bring them back in again. It's important to get the hardness right to do this. You don't want it too soft, because the tool then digs in. And you don't want it too hard either, because then it's too hard. Now, I'm doing it like that, I'm slightly inclining the tool back. This has got an angle ground on the back side there. Now every once in a while it's good just to have a look at it, just to check, because it's very easy to go off on a tangent. Yeah. The eye is very easily deceived, surprisingly. You do need to check that every once in a while. Each flute that you do is different, one from the other. Of course it is, because you're doing it by hand, they wouldn't be the same. But even with a small amount of skill doing this, you can get quite a satisfactory result. No, I know a lot of you are thinking, my goodness me, that is... Gosh, that's highly skilled work. I can't do that. Well, don't believe that. You can do it if you try. You'll be surprised with the result that you'll get. You'll surprise even yourself. So I encourage you to have a go. You can use a broken off piece of hacksaw blade, or you can use a piece of strapping like this. Well, I don't know if I'm going to have time on this clip to actually finish this jar all the way around, but I did want to just show you at least if I could get halfway around. Oh, I like this song. Oh, it's not the original, is it? It's a takeoff. Now occasionally, like, I don't know if you noticed, but there I've just picked up on a piece of dirt in the clay. And this is a time when you're doing this, if you have got any dirt in the clay, you'll pick it up on the tool. And it is a bit of a pain then. So let's have a look at him, see how we're doing. Okay, so there we have the fluting. Bit more time left, we'll do a bit more. Thing is, as I say, they're all different, these strokes, but as I say, the eye, there you are now, see that, see what's happened? Caught on a bit of grit and it's carried it down and made an ugly mark, so I've got to go over that, because I don't like that. What was I saying? They're all different, the strokes, but and I was saying that the eye is easily deceived, and when you've done the pot, you'll find that there'll be one or two of the strokes that weren't very good when you did them, and you thought, oh my goodness. But you just carry on anyway, and you'll find that the sum total of all of them, when they're all put together, your eye won't see them. You won't see the mistakes. So it's actually quite a forgiving technique. That's why I'm saying, have a go at it. And don't, for goodness sake, think that's... It's only for the likes of people like Simon Leach and all those. That's rubbish. You can do it. Just need to get on out there and determine that you will have a go. Okay, so I want to hear from you all that you've been out there fluting. It does take a little bit of skill or knack to keep the things going straight, because the natural tendency when you do that, you see, what happens is, because I'm scribing an arc basically from my elbow, so the natural tendency is it want to go off and be curved. So when I'm going down a stroke like here, I get to about here and I now got to keep going straight rather than letting my arm just And occasionally you will need to go and touch up your tool, because depending on the abrasiveness of the clay, you will... Okay, well, you can see we're almost just that little bit left to do, but I won't continue that now. Quite a nice shape. I quite like the shape. Trying to tie that in. I don't know if you can notice there's a little banding here at the top, and I quite like that because that sort of matches in with that. Plus this slight change of angle here complements it. I think it makes a nice form. So I'm quite pleased with that. Okay, folks. You've heard me say it once, you've heard me say it twice. Keep practicing. I'll see you in the next clip.